Blake, when we get into the lines, I think this should just all be the effects, don't you?
Is that what you want in there?
Yes. Here we go.
Heinz is another one of those artists that always comes up with something fresh and unique and different. He's a, you know, a brilliant composer who has these wonderful melodies in his head. You look at the Pirates theme, which you hear everywhere now. And for the third one, he created a whole bunch of new themes.
Play the downbeat of 180.
Hans has developed new themes for each of the subsequent films. Some of those themes carry into the third film that were developed for Pirates 2. There are lots of brand new themes.
I sat down and wrote over an hour's worth of new tunes. You know, it's the third one, so we want to do a really good job, and we have all these ideas that we've been talking about for, what, 3 years or so.
It could be sweetened synthetically with a, you know, a detuned piano.
Yeah.
One, you know, with the bow.
Yeah.
There's a far more eclectic sort of landscape to the movie. I think that's part of the strength of these movies, that we keep showing you worlds that you've never quite seen before. And we give you sounds that you've never heard before.
Okay, this part of our meeting is come up with ideas about other instruments. Since I already said things like banjo, it should open it up to that anything stupid you say will be hailed as a masterpiece. I mean, don't be shy. I just think we can take it a lot further than the last movie.
On this one, I'm far more active with using instruments that aren't part of the orchestra. So it does feel more like a journey, like you're truly going to the end of the world and beyond.
This next thing is like the big theme for me. Okay.
The love theme?
Well, it's actually the... It's just the theme of the whole movie. Yeah. So, a world premiere, as it were.
One of the things I think which is different in this movie, that we found a theme that binds the movie together, that takes you on this journey. At the same time, I think all journeys are inherently romantic. And so, yes, I am using it for, I'm using it as a love theme. If you ever analyze it, you know, there's a like a twist of the Johnny theme in it, which is counterimposed against the main notes of all the other themes tumbling down into hell, da 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 da. By the time I put this in front of the orchestra, all I'm worried about is this, that it's unplayable, or it'll sound like nothing that I imagined in my head. And so, it's really them that remind me, you know, after they've done a take where I was just holding my breath, you know, hoping my heart won't stop, hope there weren't any horrible accidents going to happen out there, that I can hear them having enjoyed it. I can go, oh, okay, I've written something that they actually can get their teeth into, and it elevates it straight away because they can find some sort of an emotional connection with it. That's why I love working with musicians, because that's what they do. They give you the gift of their heart.
Yeah, 25. Is that you said to play out? We can do that.
Da 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 da. You could just let it sing more, the whole thing.
It's wonderful to watch him when he has, you know, 80 musicians, and how he talks to each individual violinist to tell him exactly the pitch and the tone and the feeling that he wants. And then you add in the editors to a director who is as brilliant as Gore, Verbinski. It makes it all kind of come together.
I actually was like, where's the death toll?
Right.
Because we talked about that.
Because it's so low.
Yeah.
And like, I was like, so oh, it's there, but it, you know,
right.
I know I'm searching for it.
The reason I didn't want to be in rock and roll anymore, or didn't want to be in a band anymore, is because all you do is you talk about music. But what happens with filmmakers is very often they will ask or describe something in a way that has nothing to do with, you know, the language of music, but it sparks notes in you straight away. It,
right. More those units could come in.
But we have a bong into it.
Yeah, we've had a wonderful, like, dialogue with music throughout the cutting process with the composer Hans Zimmer just down the hall.
When they start hanging is when it should start suspending.
I think you're right.
Yeah.
We'd be able to get tracks into the system, talk about them, have meetings. He'd make adjustments and we'd get adjusted versions.
It really helps to kind of pre-visualize how, you know,
the finished film will be.
Right, where we're going with it.
It depends on the background play, but it seems like we could take a tail trim on the end of that shot.
The Avid and electronic editing has made me rethink how we do it. And rather than starting at the end of a project, why not start at the beginning while they're shooting? And why not start giving the editors music early, because it will inspire them and things will come together and you very quickly find out what doesn't work as well.
I'm saying I can play any tune through that texture. I just like the high thing and...
I think if you end up doing it better. Use that instead of that.
Some of these things go completely wrong. We have, you know, I mean, you know, this is the stuff we never talk about. When you write something and you, you know, you really believe in it and it goes completely wrong.
The descending into the splash.
Yeah.
Sort of feels like it's working and then it goes da 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 da. So kind of womp 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 instead of da 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 da.
That Gore doesn't stand up in the middle of this and go, oh my God, you're ruining my movie. You know, I mean, I think that takes character. I met Gore when he was doing Mouse Hunt, and we did Weatherman together, Pirates 2.
This is the Zimmer process.
We have everybody in the room waiting.
That's fine.
And he's writing on the
Casio. Hey, what do you think about this for Jack?
No, I think it's good. Let's get it.
It really isn't a shorthand with Gore because he's a stickler for detail. All that happens is then I try to outdo him with detail. I try to go even crazier on my orchestration, or, you know, I try to find a musician in Mongolia that he guaranteed hasn't heard of, or something like that. So we have all these cultural references, and, you know, our Fellini movies, Armor Court, and we analyze things to great levels. But the form of it, I think, is good.
Yeah, but that's going to work, right? The high note and the cross.
Right. That's what makes it so fun for me, because I'm dealing with somebody who understands my obsession about certain things and who seems to have a similar taste. We're just about to record Gore Verbinski playing the guitar. Why is he playing the guitar? Number one, because the part was written for him. Number two, because he can. Number three, because it's probably going to save the movie. And number four, because we're getting a little low on budget. He's a really good guitar player. Actually, it was interesting to do this sort of role reversal where you know, suddenly I was the director, and he was reacting the way I was reacting, by being insecure.
It's too much gain, huh? The headphones are too hot now. I mean, I can't get any more distortion.
No, but
everything's on 10.
He was saying, look, if it's no good, you can get somebody else. Look, I've said that to him 1,000 times.
I'm loving that I don't have to fire you. It's great.
Actually, Gore gave me a big gift at the end of the last movie, and he doesn't even know this. He said to Melissa, our music supervisor, he said, when Hans sits down and just plays his moody chords, something special happens. And I forgot, when I play really simply, it's very effective, you know, but there's a thing that happens, you know, where, you know, you get carried away with all the stuff on the screen and you start to get complicated. You know, he just reminded me, you know, if I just do Hans, simple, moody, you know, German. It's very effective, it's very emotional.
3 or 4 notes can make a brilliant melody, and that's what I believe in. I believe in very simple, strong melodies.
I do think we have a sound that nobody else has, and nobody else had, and even though it's humorous, it's pretty tough. I thought we were going to make the Bikers Pirate movie. I was substituting the ships for Harley-Davidson motorcycles in my mind. So there's always a rock and roll sensibility in it.
Hans has done a magnificent job to create probably the boldest and most romantic themes.
Yeah, epic sounding score.
I never forget what a great opportunity I have. People are asking me to write music. Wow, this is what I wanted my life to be about. So, you know, lucky me. Thank you.